Dear friends, welcome to Infos. Welcome to Oil and Gas Training Series. Welcome to Gas Processing Part 9, Dehydration Part 3. So I hope you have already seen and reviewed, understand my previous videos, especially on gas processing. We are now studying gas processing, now part 9. So this is dehydration part 3. So in this one, just to in last video we have discussed about the process description. I will review it. So the dehydration is the process of removal of moisture from natural gas. So a lot of reasons are there. I already explained in earlier video. So wet gas is entering through inlet knockout drum, that is here. Sometimes this inlet knockout drum is an integral part of this absorber. Sometimes it is outside, doesn't matter. So it is wet gas is entering here and removal any of liquid and any contaminants here. And wet gas is entering after removal of this free water available, entering to the absorber and going upward, and dry glycol, that is lean glycol, is entering from the top of the tower and absorption is taking place. This all process description I have explained in detail in my previous dehydration part 2, 1 and 2 videos. So kindly request you to watch that one if you didn't watch that one, to get a better idea. So then the absorption taking place and moisture is absorbing the glycol. So dry gas, you can say that one, dry gas without moisture is releasing from the top of the tower through demister pad, and demister pad will help to remove further moisture available, and it is going to outlet knockout drum. Still it is entering here and to collect some glycol carry over here and also water also. Then dry process gas out is there. Then the rich glycol coming here, and rich glycol now it is with water and we have to recycle it, regenerate it, remove water from that one, and we have to reuse it. Quickly I will explain that one. Rich glycol is entering to the top of the stripper for reheating to improve the temperature, because this one is high temperature and a low pressure, and this one is a low temperature and high pressure. So to bring down the temperature around 102 degrees C, nearly the water boiling point at atmospheric pressure. So to bring warming up, preheating here, and it is entering back to the surge drum to release any hydrocarbon condensation available. Hydrocarbon is available in that one. It is called a flash drum, and it is going to the filter to remove any particular contaminant in that one. Then it is going to lean rich heat cycle to attain the heat around maybe less than 75 degree, you can say that one. Then it is entering to the stripper, middle of the stripper, and going down to the reboiler. In the reboiler, it is maintained the temperature around 225 degrees C here, approximately, using the steam here or firing. Flue gas means natural gas fired heater, or steam, high pressure steam, high temperature, high pressure steam supply. So the heated glycol is escaping from here and moving up from here with the moisture around in the top of the stripper. It is connecting here around 109 degree, 102 around this one, and water vapor will escape. This is the process, and always this tank is the heating coil is filled with above the heating coil. The level is maintained in the above the heating coil glycol level, that is excess glycol is flowing to the surge tank. So from the surge tank it is going back, lean glycol is going back to using a booster pump and Here it is a cooling taking place because here it is a low temperature. That's why cooling taking place in the other side, lean rich glycol heat exchanger. Then the transfer pump. Again, it is maintained the proper temperature using here another heat exchanger and entering back to the absorber. This is the process. So we have to discuss here is various process variable which is affecting how it is affecting and the performance of absorber and stripper, how the effective operation taking place in this dehydration process, that we are going to discuss in this video. So conductor and absorber, the operating efficiency of a glycol gas conductor depends on, it's very important, inlet gas flow rate, temperature, pressure, as well as lean glycol concentration, temperature and circulation rates. So in the absorber, there is inlet gas flow rate is important, temperature and pressure is very, very important. And in the other side, in the stripper side, lean glycol concentration and temperature and glycol circulation rate, that is also important. So this is a small pictures just to show, understand that one, the absorption part of wherever we discuss, that part will be showing here. So number one is a very important process variable, inlet gas temperature and pressure, that is inlet temperature we will discuss here. Look at that one, is wet gas is entering from the scrubber and here it is the absorber is here. Here it's also same. The inlet gas may be assumed saturated with water vapor and therefore its water content and the quantity of water to be absorbed by the glycol depends on the inlet gas temperature and pressure. At constant pressure, the water content of the inlet gas increases as the gas temperature increases. Read one again. At constant pressure, the water content of the inlet gas increases as the gas temperature increased. Minimum inlet gas temperature is set by the viscosity of glycol being used, which is 50 degree C2 or 10 degree 15 degree Fahrenheit. Inlet gas temperature should not exceed 130 degree Fahrenheit. We can explain little more about why the gas temperature is important and fixing a temperature lower and upper value properly. You can see that one. This is a table which is giving temperature, pressure and water content. So pressure is 1000 psi, temperature is 80. So it is 33 lbs per metric million standard cubic feet. 1000, 1000, 1000, 4 temperature, pressure is constant here. See, in case temperature is increasing 80, 100, 120 and 100. It is temperature is varying here, or stay, you can say increase 80, 100 and 120 degree Fahrenheit. Here see, water content also increasing 33, 62 and 102. Correspondingly, lbs per million standard cubic feet. So increasing. So that is what is happening here. So at a constant pressure, if the temperature is increasing, water content will increase. So it is difficult to achieve proper dehydration process at a temperature is increasing above a certain level. So in other case, pressure is varying, temperature is fixing, but pressure is decreasing 800 psi to 600 psi. See the same thing, 72 to 87 increasing. Here temperature no change. So in case if pressure is decreasing or temperature is increasing, water content will vary. So it should be at the design value and optimum value and fixed. An increase in inlet gas temperature or decrease in inlet gas pressure increase the load of the unit. Load will increase in absorber. Sudden changes in pressure and temperature can affect the glycol flow in the absorber and break downcomer seals. High flow rate can cause conning that will result in bubble cap being blown from the tray. So any variation from the designed pressure or temperature, either in both side, that is increasing or decreasing, can lead decrease or affect the performance of the absorber. So that is very, very important. Gas pressure also, we can look at that one. At constant temperature, gas can hold more water as the pressure is reduced. So an increase in the same thing I explained that one earlier. Increase in the inlet gas temperature and pressure, temperature or decrease in the inlet pressure can increase the load. Sudden changes in the pressure and temperature can affect the glycol flow in the absorber and break downcomer seal. High flow rate can cause coning that will result in bubble cap being blown from the tray. So another important parameter is gas flow rate. You see that one, gas flow rate is entering the inlet separator or inlet knockout drum, then it is entering the bottom of the tower. So here any problem is there, more water is this level control system is not working, proper water is more contamination in carryover is here, everything will affect the gas flow rate. The load or the amount of water being removed per hour varies directly with the feed gas flow rate. Normally the trays are operating in a very severe spray regime. Very little liquid glycol compared to the gas flow rate. Increases in feed gas flow rate can change this delicate condition of blowing flood and can be very adverse to conductor performance. So that also the same way it is gas flow rate should be constant, and sudden changing increase or decrease will affect the performance of the absorber. Falling below the specified design range will result in loss of efficiency. Definitely the reducing the flow rate will reduce the loss of efficiency. Rising above the design range will result in reboiler overload and increase the outlet gas dew point. So next is inlet glycol temperature. You see that one, see, look at the figure for quick reference. So this is the absorber, gas flow rate is here. We have discussed about gas flow rate, inlet temperature, conductor pressure and temperature, we have discussed that one. So now another parameter is depending on the performance of the absorber is inlet glycol temperature. See that one, inlet glycol is coming from the surge tank after the removal of water vapor in stripper column, and it is coming back. What are the important area to look into that one? See, this heat exchanger performance will depend on the temperature and glycol circulation, pump performance also. Any choking is inside the pump, any problem is there, that definitely will affect the temperature and circulation. And this heat exchanger is very, very important. That also will depend or result to the perform temperature fixing. That's why here, see, it is a TT is there. So temperature controller system is providing in this area. Other than this one, booster pump performance also can depend on the temperature fixing. So it should be it should be 10 to 15 degree Fahrenheit, the inlet glycol temperature, to maintain 5 to 7 degree C above the inlet gas temperature to prevent hydrocarbon condensation in the tower, in the glycol inside the tower. The inlet glycol temperature should be 5 to 7, 15 degree higher than the gas temperature. If glycol enter cooler than the gas low temperature, then the result is resulting chilling condensation or condenses hydrocarbon, which in turn promote foaming inside the tower. The glycol enters more than 15 degree above the gas temperature, whatever the gas temperature, it should be in this range, 5 to 15 degree Fahrenheit. Or above the 15 degree Fahrenheit gas temperature, TEG vaporization losses and gas dew points are increased unnecessarily. So both conditions, it is adverse effect to the absorber. So temperature is glycol circulation. Glycol temperature is inlet in is very very important inside the entire operation. So dehydration temperature is also very very important. While TG can dehydrate natural gas at operating temperature of 50 to 130 degree Fahrenheit, the preferred operating temperature range is normally 80 to 100 degree Fahrenheit. So this is the preferred operating range of temperature, 80 to 100 degree Fahrenheit. Below 70 degree Fahrenheit, glycol is too viscous. This reduces stray efficiency, promote foaming, and increase glycol losses. Above 110 degree Fahrenheit, the inlet gas contains too much water and the drying ability of glycol is reduced. This is very very important. If you are working in the plant and get a chance to see the temperature in the tower absorber, just to go and see that in this old temperature, glycol temperature, absorber temperature, inlet gas temperature, etc., etc., you have to monitor and understand the importance of that one and read the processor description and operating parameters for how they are fixing and what is the range for better operation. Next parameter is important for performance of the absorber is glycol concentration. Glycol's concentration means glycol purity. If more contamination in glycol, it will depend on the performance of the dehydration. So higher dew point depression can be obtained with higher glycol concentration. So better, more concentration, more purity, more dehydration will take place. TEG temperature and concentration. The ability of the drying ability of TEG is limited by the vapor liquid equilibrium of water between the gas phase and the liquid TEG phase. The drying ability of TEG increases dramatically with the concentration. See, temperature is fixed 100, glycol purity is 98 and 99 and 99.5 and 99.7. See, the dew point is 32 at 98, then 99, it is drastically down, come down. It is 16 degree Fahrenheit now, dew point temperature, and 99.5, it is zero. See, and 99.7, purity is increased and it is minus 16 degree Fahrenheit. So better result will get at a higher purity. So we have to maintain the glycol purity. At least the standard operating is 99.5. This range we have to operate. Let us see how we can achieve this glycol concentration or circulation glycol purity maximum. So one is glycol circulation rate. An excessive glycol circulation rate can result in the following problems: increased fuel consumption and exceeded reboiler capacity and increased overhead. Increased overhead glycol loss, increased pump maintenance. So the circulation rate is changing. Then these all fuel consumption increase, reboiler capacity will increase, overhead glycol loss will be more, and pump maintenance. So we have to watch that circulation pump and booster pump and circulation pump plus surge tank level also. This all three parameter will depend on the excess or low circulation rate in this tower, in this glycol. So care of that one, glycol circulation pump should be maintained properly. Booster pump also same level to maintain in good condition. Surge tank level also we have to watch regularly. Heat exchanger problem also, any heat exchanger choking can also decrease or increase or decrease, mainly decrease the circulation rate. Now coming back to still column, we have to, the mainly the purity is fixing here, glycol purity. So the process quickly will explain that one. The purity or concentration of lean glycol solution is the ultimate means of controlling the quantity of water vapor that is removed from the gas. The purity of glycol required depend upon the temperature of the inlet gas to the conductor and the required dew point of the outlet gas. The conductor pressure and glycol flow rate have no bearing on glycol purity. The reconcentration of glycol is controlled. Reconcentration, that is important. Once it is going to the regeneration section, that is stripper section, then that is controlled in the still column and reboiler. So reboiler is process parameter is very important, and still column process operation and parameter, any choking inside is very, very important. Let us review that one. Though the TEG solution is heated to a temperature between 380 to 400 degree Fahrenheit in the reboiler. See, it is there, 300 to 480 degree Fahrenheit. At this temperature, the TEG purity should be 98.5, what we want to the design level, to the best performance in absorber. While the degree of glycol reconcentration depends mainly on the reboiler temperature, additional reconcentration is easily obtainable by use of a stripping gas. See, some stripping gas, fuel gas is stripping here. See, in the stripping column, some system, not available in some of the plants, but some of the plants are using this stripping gas. That's why I am not much discussing about that one. Glycol losses from the top of the stripping column can be minimized by temperature control. See, using the temperature control here, in the reboiler and in the top. Also, we can maintain this column proper working properly, efficiently, plus that is glycol losses, and we can maintain the glycol purity. So, reflux, this temperature is the coil is a reflux coil is connected here in the top of this one, and maintaining the overhead temperature nearly 102 degrees C at atmospheric pressure. So reboiler temperature is very, very, very important. Higher temperature at constant pressure result in greater glycol purity. The range should be 380 to 400 degree Fahrenheit, that is 193 to 204. Earlier I told 210, but it is 204. The temperature should not exceed 404. That is 207. Otherwise, glycol degradation will result. So, temperature should be very critical and it should not exceed around 207. It should not go below 193 as well. So, that is a reboiler temperature is fixing by thermo temperature control system. Whatever the burners and other control system is using for to temperature fixing, maintaining proper temperature. The concentration of lean glycol is leaving the reboiler varies with the reboiler temperature and pressure. The reboiler normally operates at atmospheric pressure or slightly positive. Concentration of 98.5 weight percentage should be achievable with a reboiler temperature around 400 degree Fahrenheit. The higher concentration of stripping gas is required. Still overhead temperature, another one I have marked here. The recommended range is 212 degree Fahrenheit to 215, that is 100 to 102. That is exactly what I told, is a boiling point of water at atmospheric pressure. Lower temperature can cause a reboiler overload and excessive fuel consumption here. Higher temperature can cause glycol loss due to vaporization. That is issue here, problems facing here with higher and lower temperature. So the how we are maintaining that one? Maintaining a reflux coil is here. That's why we can maintain here. The temperature of top of stripping column should be kept approximately 210 degree Fahrenheit, preferably by varying the flow of rich inlet glycol to a reflux generating cooling coil located at the top of the still. Here some coils are providing inside the top of the tower, maintaining the temperature at around 100 degree to 102 degree C. That's also very important. Another some of the important one is the regenerator pressure. It is atmospheric pressure. There is no much difference on that one. The regenerator pressure is normally atmospheric pressure. A build-up pressure indicated plugging or flooding in the problem. An increase in the pressure prevents some water from boiling out of the glycol. Our filter pressure also, in the filter we have discussed earlier, filter is using to remove the contamination in glycol before entering to the stripper. A pressure drop of 3 to 6 psi is normal. When the pressure drop is reached at 10 to 20 psi, the element should be replaced, indication of plugging. Another one is the heat exchanger temperature. Very, very important in the lean rich heat exchanger, and another inlet final heat exchanger, means glycol heat exchanger. Decrease differential pressure between inlet and outlet glycol heat indicate exchanger fouling. That also very important parameter. Glycol losses is another one. The loss of glycol losses is a costly operating problem. Location of glycol losses are carryover with the gas leaving the conductor. In the absorber, there is a chance of glycol losses is possibly happening. And vaporization with water vapor in the steel column, leak from the pump or pipe fitting, removal of liquid hydrocarbon in the flash drum. These are the four area you can see that one. Another one is still high still over temperature. We have discussed that one. Conductor column operating excessive gas rate, that is a flow rate, forming rapid changes in gas rate. These all are possible reasons of glycol losses. I hope you have understand the dehydration process parameters, which is severely affecting the performance of the absorber and steel column and entire dehydration process. Hopefully in our next class we will discuss about how to read the P&ID and understand the process alarms and variable set point, process variable set point and trip conditions, etc., etc. Thanks for watching this video. From now we have running on a course, paid course on advanced online course for groups, companies in a corporate environment, like institutions, a group of students, and like companies, those who are working in a department, and training we can provide. Like it's a combined training on oil and gas operation, processes involved like reservoir, wellhead, flow line, manifold, gathering station, oil treatment, gas treatment, storage, export and metering. Then mechanical, static equipment, heat exchanger, separator, valves, pipeline, rotating equipment. The entire program include overall idea on process, mechanical, instrumentation, electrical and safety. So it's a 5-month course, 1 hour per day, 3 weeks per week, 12 to 15 hour per month. So we can condense or we can reduce and increase the area according to the company's requirement. But in general, it is a 5-month course. Course highlight practical oriented approach, more case studies, homeworks, suitable timings, recorded classes, end of module assignment, end of module exams, training material and certificate. So these are the, this one we will, we are already running a batch from August onwards. So the second batch is starting from September 1st. If any of you, your group or your company or your institution are interested to join this one, please contact me on my name, WhatsApp number and email is there. So thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe this channel for timely updates and information. And please join in our Telegram channel by Infos for various updates. Thanks for watching. Definitely we will coming with another video on dehydration and gas processing soon. Thank you.